Congress is asking what else Kanhaiya is bringing other than Muslims and Dalits. After losing 2019 Lok Sabha elections, he had not been in the news much. Kanhaiya wants some kind of space. He would be looking for rebooting his politics. It's quite surprising. Post his rallies on against CA and NPR, he has not said much. Even I think, if I correctly remember, he had not been active on Twitter for 2.5 months. So that's very tactical of him to do so. He does it very often. He doesn't want to say much. Somewhere down the line, he wants to reboot his politics. He doesn't want to carry an image of a guy who is strong, carrying anti-BJP image. So somewhere he's just trying to be more assimilative in his politics so that he can look beyond that pitch, because that pitch is over. He has done that during the anti-CAA protest quite successfully, also got the crowd traction, especially from youth, Muslim, Dalits. But that is his problem. Congress is asking what else Kanhaiya is bringing other than Muslims and Dalits. That is his problem lies. So he just wants to redo his politics now. Okay, I come from JNU. I came into limelight because of wrong reasons, because of a case, sedition case against me. But see, I am traveling. I am talking about development. I am talking about education. He had been during that anti-CA rally, he did speak of those things. So maybe it is not the right time. It's not an election time. So I think he's buying his time. There are two ways to look at Kanhaiya's meeting with Bihar Minister Ashok Kumar Chaudhary. First, after losing 2019 Lok Sabha elections, he had not been in the news much. Though he had been in news for his rallies for the NPR or CA protest during the, I think, early 2020, before COVID struck in the entire country and the rest part of the world. So what is Kanhaiya saying that he just met as a representative from Begusarai? He's not a public elected representative, just a political leader, CPI leader from Begusarai. Bakhri is a place in Begusarai. It's a subdivision town. He has been pressing for a college in Bakhri. So he said he met the education minister with this request. And education minister, we just spoke to him. He also corroborated that. I know Kanhaiya Kumar for a long time. He met me to just repeat that request. Anybody can meet a politician from any political divide. So people must not read too much into it. Nitish Kumar also yesterday clarified that one should not look too much into it. So, but that's one thing. But second thing, what I am saying is there could be one way from Kanhaiya to put some pressure on RJD, which has not been valuing Kanhaiya Kumar. Of course, with the presence of Tejaswi Yadav, because they are both are young leaders. Kanhaiya is more dynamic than him. He is a better speaker than Tejaswi. So there is some kind of rivalry. But he wants some kind of space. Kanhaiya wants some kind of space. He would be looking for rebooting his politics. But that is not happening now. 2025 is a long time. Even Lok Sabha election is in 14. So 6 months down the line, he might think of something beyond CPI. As you know, CPI as a party doesn't have a structure, doesn't have a sound structure in Bihar, sound and presence in Bihar. So a leader like Kanhaiya has to look beyond his party. I don't know whether Congress could be his destination or JDU could be his destination. But so long JDU is part of NDA alliance, Kanhaiya is not going, I don't think Kanhaiya could be part of it, because his politics is anti-BJP politics. Any party which is an alliance partner of BJP cannot be Kanhaiya's next destination. That way politics would be finished. And plus, he is still been facing sedition charges. Once those charges, if he is acquitted of those charges, then a party like JDU can think about Kanaiya. But for now, I think it's gesturing. It's just a political gesturing. We should not try to read between the lines as of now. Kanaiya had been always been soft at Nitish Kumar. He has seldom attacked Nitish Kumar. That's part one. It's quite tactical. He has been attacking RJD more, even though CPI was part of the Grand Alliance. But he has not attacked enough. And Kanaiya wasn't used in the election. He didn't campaign much because of his polarizing image. Even CPI or even the Grand Alliance leaders didn't use him beyond a point in the safe seat for some constituency of Begusarai with a sizable Muslim and Dalit population. So, in that sense, yes, he wants to keep his options open. So must be something in mind. But for right now, I do not see that happening. CPI is not a very active party, for that matter, left. And only the CPI ML has good presence, not just because they have won some seats. Even before that, they have a strong cadre. CPI has been a dormant party. What it used to be, I think, still till late 90s, it used to have good presence. But post 2000, it doesn't have much presence. So it is not trying to use a potential of a leader of Kanaiya's stature. The kind of rebel Roger he is, the kind of terrific speaker he is. CPI is not using that. That's why Kanaiya must be feeling suffocated somehow. And it would not surprise he thinks something out of the box, or thinks his life beyond CPI in days to come.